I hope you're doing well.
Welcome to a traditional ASMR video that hopefully will help you to relax. Hopefully by now it's already started to happen. To concentrate. In case you use these videos to work, to help you with your work or your studies. To sleep. And probably just as important, sleeping and relaxing. To calm your mind. Especially if you had a overactive mind, always thinking, and beyond that, I hope this video helps you if you are dealing with anything such as panic attacks, anxiety, PTSD, something as simple as a headache, or any other number of things that often can just cause our minds to be a little more troubled or carry a little more weight than we would like. So, I hope you've been well, and I hope that you're able to continue to progress in your life and keep moving forward down your own path in life. So, of course, as you can tell by the title of this video, as well as the visuals and environment themselves, I'm here in our little garage. I wasn't expecting to film this video here, but I thought, why not take a chance? That's all I've ever been doing throughout my life, and taking risks, and I hope that you do the same, because we never know what might happen. Sometimes good, sometimes bad. But there's always personal growth involved. So, I thought you would start with a singing bowl. Because this is a little louder than the rest of the sounds, I figured I would do this first. And that way, you can always skip the beginning part of this video. Don't happen to like the sound. hope you enjoyed that. It almost doesn't make much sense for me to tap on this book with the sounds overhead. Since the sounds are pretty much competing with each other. But I want to let you know that probably a week from this video, I will be doing the next Dungeons and Dragons video where I create a character, so I wanted to just squeeze this in here for those of you interested in that video. And the same goes for the Bloodborne roleplay. So, as you probably, hopefully, maybe have seen in the non-speaking traditional ASMR video published before this one, I would just read a few excerpts from Friedrich Nietzsche's Thus Spoke Zarathustra. I'm not sure if you've had a chance to look into Nietzsche, but I would recommend it. Just with anything to expand your horizons, your perspective. You can hear these sounds. I didn't really know how loud the rain was going to be. Hopefully it's still enjoyable. See what we have. the rabble. Life is a well of delight, but where the rabble also drink, there all fountains are poison. To everything cleanly am I well disposed, but I hate to see the grinning mouths and the thirst of the unclean. They cast their eye down into the fountain, and now glanceth up to me their odious smile out of the fountain. The holy water they have poisoned with their lustfulness, and when they call their filthy dreams delight, then poison they also the words. Indignant becometh the flame when they put their damp hearts to the fire. The spirit itself bubbleth and smoketh when the rabble approach the fire. Mawkish and over-mellow becometh the fruit in their hands, unsteady and withered at the top. Doth their look make the fruit tree. Definitely an old style of writing. This book was meant to be written in that manner, from what I understand. As Nietzsche is writing, as if he were another character. The soothsayer. And I saw a great sadness come over mankind, the best turned weary of their works. A doctrine appeared, a faith ran beside it. All is empty, all is alike, all hath been, and from all hills there re-echoed. All is empty, all is alike, all hath been. To be sure we have harvested, but why have all our fruits become rotten and brown? What was it fell last night from the evil moon? In vain was all our labor. Poison hath our wine become. The evil eye hath singed yellow our fields and hearts. And have we all become, and fire fallen upon us. Then do we turn dust like ashes. Yea, the fire itself have we made a weird. This is basically Nietzsche, somewhat poetically, creatively expressing his own philosophies. It's quite difficult to understand. I have a question for thee alone, my brother, like a sounding lead, sounding lead. Cast I this question into thy soul, that I may know its depth. Thou art young, and desirest child and marriage, but I ask thee, art thou a man entitled to to desire a child? Art thou the victorious one, the self-conqueror, the ruler of thy passions, the master of thy virtues? Thus do I ask thee. Or doth the animal, or doth the animal speak in thy wish, and necessity, or isolation, or discord in thee? I would have thy victory and freedom long for a child. Living monuments shalt thou build to thy victory and emancipation. Beyond thyself shalt thou build. But first of all must thou be built thyself, rectangular in body and soul. Not only onward shalt thou propagate thyself, but upward. For that purpose may the garden of marriage help thee. A higher body shalt thou create, a first movement, a spontaneously rolling wheel, a creating one shalt thou create. So, just a few excerpts. Maybe in a future video, like this, where it rains, I'll do nothing but read. I hope that you are feeling nice and relaxed by now. I hope that your mind has already begun to calm and settle. I don't even know if there's much point in me making tapping sounds in this video. Since Mother Nature is, or the universe, is pretty much doing that for me. This is an old medical book, Health Knowledge, Volume 2. Thirty-four departments, scientifically illustrated. I purchased this when I went to a vintage sale where I found it. Scythe, I think that's how you pronounce it, the Grim Reaper, and the taxidermied fox, and some other vintage items. Health knowledge, a thorough and concise knowledge of the prevention, causes, and treatments of disease, simplified for home use. 34 departments, including prenatal care and the care of infants, health in childhood, pregnancy and motherhood, women's physical changes and their disorders, diseases of women, physical culture and deep breathing exercises for men and women, physical culture and massage for infants, foods and their values, home nursing, home remedies, medical prescriptions in Latin and English, plants, vegetables, fruits, and herbs. Editor-in-Chief J.L. Korish, M.D., formerly associated with the Brooklyn Eastern District Hospital, Manhattan Eye and Ear Hospital, New York City, medical SUPT, period. So I'm not sure what that abbreviation stands for. The New York State Home at Fort Hamilton, New York. Volume 2, Domestic Health Society, 1923. What's most fascinating about this book, aside from its age, is the verbiage and the language and the mindsets back then, 100 years ago, 90 years ago, 1923, so 90-something. I'm not gonna math. Copyright 1919. So, here are some of the herbs, I suppose. Indian turnip. This common herb grows all over the United States. It is called dragon root and jack of the pulpit, and is found as a three-leaved plant with berries of a bright scarlet color. When fresh, the root is a powerfully strong stimulant. It makes an excellent poultice for swollen glands of the neck. When dried and pulverized, it is a good remedy for coughs and pains in the breasts. And it still has this aged smell to it. Dusty old smell. Some pictures of illustrations of someone with a disease. Two of my favorite parts. Plague. Bubonic plague. Pestilence. I really ought to have the plague doctor read this part. Plague is the name of an infectious epidemic disease common to man and many of the lower animals. Its main characters are fever, swelling of the lymphatic glands, a rapid course, and a very high mortality, which has made it a much dreaded scourge. In the Middle Ages, it was known as the Black Death, which again and again ravaged Europe. Though for the past century, it's about time the thunder showed up. Though for the past century, it has been almost confined to warm climates. Just an interesting book. Where's the skeleton, the human skeleton, the bony framework which supports the soft tissues of the body and protects the internal organs, may be considered under the subdivisions of the axial skeleton, comprising the skull, including the teeth, and the hyoid bone, the spinal column, the ribs, and the sternum, or the breastbone, and the appendicular skeleton, comprising the bones of the limbs together with the bony girdles which support them. Alright, just look at one more section for whatever I find here. So, the index in the back. Of medical terms. Care of the feet. Sweating feet. In hot weather, this is a common and troublesome complaint. As a result of its blisters and sores may develop. Especially on the feet of those who walk a good deal. Prevention and treatment of sweating feet. Feet should be washed in salt water every night and carefully dried. Special attention being paid to the spaces between the toes. A fresh pair of woolen socks, well dusted inside with boracic powder, should be worn each day. If blisters develop, prick them with a needle which has been sterilized by holding it in a gas flame for a minute. Then apply a piece of lint covered with zinc ointment. So, it's maybe I'll spend a video and go through it in more detail. See any of this? Give it a try. Okay, we have Lake Superior, Apostle Islands National Lakeshore. Just try to hold this a little closer for you. Okay. Duluth, Hermantown. We have luck. Not exactly sure of the Route 53 comes down along here. It looks like it ends at a No, it doesn't end. There you have it, becomes blue. Not sure what the difference is between orange and blue. There is a, let's see here, a multi-lane highway and a limited access multi-lane highway free or toll. Okay. So it's a multi-lane highway, and then it may become a toll. I'm just gonna see what else. Probably spend another video going through this as well. How about my home state of Pennsylvania? Oops. So let's switch sides just for a little bit. Okay. So, hopefully you can see Philadelphia, north of Cheltenham. Here's I-95, and that goes all the way up from Florida. Interstate 95, I'm not sure how far north it goes. Pennsylvania, New Jersey border, of the Delaware River. This is all Philadelphia, because the major district. I'm not sure why it's white. Maybe this is Philadelphia and this is not. I would assume. Yeah, central Philadelphia. Pennsylvania Convention Center. Market Street Station. City Hall. Some other towns. Melrose Park, Windmore, Lafayette Hill, Plymouth, Maine, Norristown, Havertown, Drexel Hill, Clifton Heights, Yaden, Glen Ullin, I-76, which is a major, another big road, access route. A lot of folks use this to travel to and from work, as well as 95. Let's see, how about California? Los Angeles, Santa Monica Mountains, Thousand Oaks, Route 405. I'm not familiar at all with California. Burbank, Glendale, Santa Clarita, not sure. Angeles National Forest. I'm assuming you pronounce that like Los Angeles. San Gabriel Mountains National Monument. So we have Route 5 right here. Let's go this way. We have Route 118. Beverly Hills. West Hollywood. Hollywood Freeway. Yeah, so maybe we'll take a, here's Pasadena. Los Angeles. Route 110. Santa Monica Municipal Airport. Santa Monica Bay. Malibu. So maybe we'll spend, like I said, some time. Maybe actually we'll do that. Sooner than later. We'll see. So I still hope that you're either asleep and don't overhear a word I'm saying right now, or you're still awake but in a nice, peaceful, restful state. Take a look at some albums that I've acquired, purchased. This is Tool. The band, the band tour, the album Undertow. This has always been my favorite album. It's very aggressive. The lyrics are great. All of the lyrics are great with all of Tool's albums, actually. They have a big four undertow of forks. Symbolic. Side A, intolerance. Prison sex. Sober. Those are pretty much the singles. Well, those are the first two singles, or the only singles. Anyway, those are the first two videos I've ever saw of the band, which was just mind-blowing to hear their style, their music, back in the mid-90s. Bottom, Call Away, Swamp Song, Undertow, title track, 4 Degrees, Flood, and Disgusticated. So there's two albums in here. Nothing too fancy to remember with the records themselves. Iron Maiden, Number of the Beast. This was a gift. We have Invaders, Children of the Damned, The Prisoner, 22 Acacia Avenue, The Number of the Beast, Run to the Hills, Gangland, Hallowed Be Thy Name. This entire album, I think, is just full of great songs. Gangland, maybe not too much, but Invaders, Children of the Damned, maybe not too much, but I would say the whole album is pretty good, classic. This is my other Tool album. I don't have all of them. This is Lateralus. Right now, this is what I have been listening to for the past couple months. Love this album. It's two LPs. And I'm gonna have to. Don't know all the tracks by heart. The Grudge, Neon Blue Apocalypse, The Patient, Mantra, Schism, Parable, Parabola, Disposition. And we'll take out Blood on Album. And Nietzsche's, Lateralus, Inflection, Triad, and Five Day Wave. I don't know how to pronounce that, but I probably butchered it. Music has always been an important part of my life. Maybe it's safe to guess it's equally important part of yours as well, and so many of our lives. Don't know what we would do without it as a species. David Bowie, rest in peace. Let's Dance. Modern Love. China Girl, Let's Dance. That's really the only songs that I really like. It's Without You, Ricochet, Criminal World, Cat People, Putting Out Fire, and Shake It. Billy Joel, Shadow Man. This album isn't that great, except for the title track. I like one of his, he has a best greatest hits, which I would actually prefer to own. Let's see, Captain Jack, Travel and Prayer, Worst Comes to Worst, Stop in Nevada, The Ballad of Billy the Kid, Somewhere Along the Line, Piano Man, If I Only Had the Words to Tell You, You're My Home, Ain't No Crime. So really, Captain Jack and Piano Man are probably the only tracks that I really care for. So, I have a few more albums, but since we're getting late into this video, I don't spend so much time on just those few things. So, how about instead of just doing, how about instead of just doing any more trigger sounds or object exploration, I'll just kind of ramble a little bit. Is that alright? So, if you're still awake, I hope that you're able to, well, let me preface what I'm about to say by saying that if you're dealing with anxiety, depression, PTSD, that I hope that you're able to work towards a much more calmer and peaceful state of mind with each day and each step that you take on your path in life. I still deal with anxiety and, you know, it depends on the situation, and I kind of talked about the residual effects of depression and things that I've gone through, but, you know, it takes time, and I can only tell you from experience that you just need to be patient with yourself, with the world, and just take one moment at a time, one day at a time. You know, make sure that you find something constructive to do. Take your mind off things. Make sure you eat healthy the best you can. I still cheat and have eat at Burger King or have pizza, but I still eat my vegetables and drink plenty of water. plenty of exercise. Exercise is so important. You know, 15 minutes a day, a couple times a day, and it's really important. Even if you don't have a park to go to or any really place to go, you can still exercise in your flat, your apartment, your home. You know, you can do jumping jacks, you can stretching exercises, yoga, sit-ups, push-ups, you know, walking in place, just something to physically will yourself through whatever current hardship you might be experiencing. I found that it works for me. Sometimes I just will. It's difficult if you're working, but at night, on the weekend, sometimes you just have to. Motivate yourself. You have to will yourself. You have to be driven. It's difficult if you're depressed or whatever might be bothering you. I know the last thing you want to do is get out of bed sometimes, but you just have to make yourself sometimes. You really do. And that's one of those moments. It's like a building block. And you do that, and you build, and you build, and you build, and you build. That's how you get out of those moments. Now, I'm not going to say it works every time. I'm not a health professional at all. I can only tell you it works from experience. So, but, well, that's going to do it. This was a very impromptu video, not very conducive for exploring different sounds, but I still hope you found it to be very calming, soothing, relaxing, able to concentrate with your studies, with your work, hopefully fall asleep. Most importantly, I hope this has helped you in some way to feel better, mentally especially. Okay, so I'm just gonna let this the rain take us out, and stay tuned for another video right after this one. Take care of yourself, and I wish you all my very best. As I said, on your own path in life, it's going to be full of hurdles and obstacles. Every day, sometimes, is like that. But the more you work, the more you want, the more you will yourself to get through them, the more you grow. And the more confidence, the more strength you can find within yourself to conquer those situations should they arise again. All right? Care of yourself. It was great to see you. Thank you very much for joining me. I'm honored to have spent some of this time with you. Take care now. See you soon. Bye.